Good morning, everyone. Please take a seat. Obviously, we had a wonderful weekend last weekend, and I've got a few thank yous from that. So from Richard and Anne Hardwick, I had an email saying just a big thank you for a lovely day yesterday. Can you not? Can you hear me now? I can hear me on the mic. Sorry, so a wonderful weekend last weekend. We've had some thank yous about that. So the first one is an email from Richard and Anne Hardwick just saying a big thank you for a lovely day yesterday. That would have been Sunday. It was so good to catch up with members of the church and those who travelled to take part in the bicentenary celebrations and to be welcomed with so much kindness. And they said, we've been trying to think of any other Baptist churches in Northamptonshire still worshipping who have celebrated 200 years of service. I need to look into that one because I'm not too sure. I know Moulton were definitely, obviously, here before us and are still worshipping together. And then from Sarah and Jonathan Lee, who are the curates at St John's, thank you so much for having us for lunch yesterday. It was a lovely occasion and the food was excellent. What a wonderful way to celebrate 200 years of the Baptist Church in Kingsthorpe. Congratulations, and we hope there will be many more future happy celebrations in years to come. And then, as last week, we had two cards. We've got another card today. And this is from Martin and Sue Buckby, and I just need to put these on to read it. So it was actually to Bob and Janet. Dear Bob and Janet, please would you convey our thanks to all the people who put such hard work into making the 200 year anniversary of Kingsthorpe Baptist Church such a wonderful success. For the displays in the church on Saturday to the delicious meal on Sunday. With our thanks and very best wishes, Martin and Sue Buckby. So thanks again everyone who took part in any way in last weekend's celebrations. And then just another notice, Lois had another garden party yesterday morning in aid of Christian Aid, and a total of £727 was raised. So I'm sure Lois passes on her thanks to everyone who was involved in that. So there's nothing else for me to say other than to welcome Adrian, who I think we might know a little bit.
Thank you, Catherine, for that. I think one thing more to say is that Catherine's brother-in-law in America died this week. So we'll be remembering her sister Sam and daughter Nikki in America. Funeral's going to be on this Wednesday. Everything else, Catherine's not going to be able to go across to America. But we remember Catherine, we remember her sister and family in America, especially at this time. We've come to worship God. We've got another of our all-age worship services today, which is an excuse for making sure everybody takes part in it, particularly young people and anything else. What I would say is, are there any young people in the church, if they need a bit of exercise and roam around, That doesn't bother me, and I'm sure we'll all be happy about it. As long as they don't come up and bite my ankles, I'm going to be happy. Okay. And we're thinking today about the verse in the Bible where Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to the Father except by me." Let's have a prayer. Lord, we are here to worship you. Please speak to us, move amongst us, and touch our hearts afresh with your love, that your name may be glorified here today. Amen. We're now going to join in with a song, "Lord, I Lift Your Name on High," 897 in Songs of Fellowship, and we're going to sing along to a YouTube video version of the song. Lord, I lift your name on high. Let us stand and sing.
Sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
There's a little whistle. Okay, can you turn it down a little? That's better. How are we doing? It's okay there. Can you, everybody hear me? Yeah. No? Very well. Let's swap over. Okay, that's better, isn't it? Okay, a map. We're all used to using maps and getting directions, aren't we? We're thinking about Jesus saying he said, I am the way. He is a guide. Now, what I want is a couple of volunteers. One who's going to be blindfolded, and the other one who is going to give directions for the one who is blindfolded to get around. They've got a volunteer there, so we need to come out the front. We've got another. Yeah, I suspect we. You're going to be the volunteer. Okay. In which case, Stephanie's after something. Okay. We'll try again in a minute. Okay. So you're the one who's going to be blindfolded. Because. Can you just put that on? And you can't see, can you?
No.
No. Okay. Now, Steve, if you just sort of walk over here a bit. Okay, if you stand there, what I would like you to do, sorry, I've forgotten your name.
Jodie.
Jodie. So what I'd like you to do is to tell him what he has to do to move to get up onto the platform by the screen. So you're going to have to say things like to take 3 paces forward and stop, turn right, stop, take 1 pace forward, step up 1 step. You understand what we're doing? Okay, do you want to start? What's the first thing you want to tell him to do?
5 steps forward. 3 more steps forward. Turn right. Three steps forward. Two steps forward. One step to the left. A small step to the right.
A smaller step to the right.
One more step forward. Step up and forward. Another step up and forward. Three steps forward. And turn around.
Thank you very much. And you can take the blindfold off now, Steve. Thank you. How confident did you feel there, Steve?
Yeah, I felt fairly safe. Jody was a good instructor. And I took it slowly.
Yeah. But taking that, but it was, you were uncertain at times, weren't you? I saw when you got up the top here, you were sort of thinking,
where am I?
Trying to think, well, a very familiar place, but you didn't really quite know where things were, I think, at times. Anyway,
that's right, yes.
So thanks very much for that. Yeah. So he gets all sorts of guidance. When we go in a car, how many people use sat-nav? Parents use sat-nav. Does it always take you where you want to go?
Some of the time.
Some of the time. I got these pictures. Sat-nav, wrong use brain.
for the Fortway, do not follow sat-nav. Long vehicles prohibited, do not follow sat-nav. And if we blindly follow instructions, got a few pictures here of what people have got, trouble they've got into, having to be dragged out by a tractor, ending up in a Ford, stuck under a low bridge, wedged. I can remember doing this in a minibus once. I got to a point where I knew the route and I was going down, and it got narrower and narrower and narrower in a road in Devon. And I got about a mile down the road and I ended up realizing if I went any further forward, I was going to be in that position. It was a Boys Brigade camp week. So I'd in a minibus with a load of Boys Brigade boys. And I then had to reverse about a mile back because there was no room to turn round to get back. It wasn't a pleasant experience at the time. But we have all sorts of things giving us directions. And as I said, in the Bible, Jesus said he is the way. Sort of found this cartoon. I told you to ask for directions. Sounds like Stephanie. But I thought all roads lead to God. This is the cartoon. It's a thought, isn't it? How do we get to heaven? Wouldn't it be wonderful if there was someone who could actually show us the way to heaven? And what I've got now is our reading from John chapter 14.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there are not, I should have told you. I'm going to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. If you know me, you know my Father too. From this moment, you know him, and you have seen him." Philip said, "Lord, let us see the Father, and then we shall be satisfied. Been with you all this time, Philip," said Jesus to him, "and you still do not know me? To have seen me is to have seen my Father. So how can you say, 'Let us see the Father'? Do you not believe that I am the Father and the Father is in me? The words I say to you, I do not speak as myself. It is the Father living in me who is doing this work. You must believe me when I say that I am the Father and the Father is in me. Believe it in the evidence of this work, if for no other reason. I tell you most solemnly, whoever believes in me will perform the same works as I do myself. He will perform even greater works because I am going to the Father.
Is that it? That's working, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. Okay. Hope you listened to the Bible reading, because I've got a question on it. Who, according to that Bible reading, can show us the way to the Father's house? In other words, heaven. Oh dear. Jesus. That's right, Jesus. But he didn't say, I can show you the way. What he actually said is, I am the way. If we want to get to our Father's house, then we need to go with Jesus. Isn't that the best way of getting directions? When we ask somebody the way to somewhere, they don't just say, well, you go down there to the Fox and Duck pub and you turn right. And then if you get to the Bold Dragoon, you've gone too far. You know, we all had directions like that at the time. The best directions are when somebody says, I'll actually come with you. I'll actually show you the way. So what we're going to do now is get Martin to come up and to get rid of our cobwebs, I think is, yeah, should be on.
Hello, yep, hello, right. I've been asked to do something sort of more interactive with you. So all the children, and by that, I mean, anybody who's below, let's go with 16 for now. Do you want to all come down the front a minute? Cause I'm feeling very lonely. Come sit down on here just a second. I'm going to get you up the front in a minute. All right. Now, any adults who feel like a child, you can come down and join us. You're going to join in anyway, so. Right. How many of you chose your family? Oh, you put your hand up before I even finished the question. How many of you chose your family? Did you? Oh, right. Okay. That's a new one, isn't it? We don't usually choose our family. That's that old phrase, isn't there? You can choose your family, or you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family. So we're going to choose. How many of you have chosen friends? How many of you have got friends? Did you? Right. So your friends can sometimes get you to try and follow them, can't they? Pop your hands down again. Okay. So your friends can sometimes get you to follow them. And sometimes, although we've got what we call good friends, sometimes they can lead us in the wrong direction, but sometimes they can lead us in the right direction. Who is, should know the answer to this already now, who is the best friend to have? Ta-da! Who do you think is? Jesus. So we're going to do a song. All right. Now this is going to wake all the adults up as well. I'm going to have to put the microphone down a minute because it's got some actions to it. This is where all the adults go, oh no, he's not doing action songs. Right. It says an action song. And yes, I do expect you to support me and join in. Okay. So anybody who lived through the '60s will remember these actions. Okay. Pardon? Really? Right, ready. Now, first lot of actions is this. I'm going to have to put the microphone down because I can't do the action for the microphone.
Right, so the first lot of action is, with your hand on, just think of the hand job. Right, so we're going, so I think it's a hand job, isn't it? Yeah, so they have the words like this. Great, great. One in. Great, great. Real, great. Mega. Steal. To have a friend like Jesus. Okay? Now we repeat that. So see if we can do that right. Break, 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 break Can we do it again? Pray the way of the man in Jesus' name. Come to him by Jesus. Pray the way of the man in Jesus' name. Come to him by Jesus. He's always there. He always listens. He always hears me when I talk to him. He loves me now, and he will forever. I'll choose for him every day. Alright? Okay, so what you'll find is the words that you're looking at, it's quite a fast one. It's quite a long issue in the worship. You want to all stand up. You've got to go through the song, right? Do the action. And if you want, talk to the other one. Yeah. I want you to join in. Okay? Alright? So, ready? If you can have a minute to pick step three.
I'm just going to say, are you glad I didn't ask you to play that on the organ? Right, so Jesus is the best friend you can have. And we've just heard in that reading that Jesus said, I am the way. Right? So if Jesus tells you to go in a direction, it's the right direction. Okay? So I'm now going to do something else with you. He says, if you don't break his iPad in the time. Put that on. Oh, yeah. Yeah, sorry. He's got an introduction for you. How many of you watch this program? Some of you do, right. Well, I'm not doing it like the program. So adults can listen to this because you might want to answer, see how good you are at these things. Now, children. I don't think church should be boring, and I don't think children should be quiet in church particularly. That's my opinion, okay? So I'm going to get you up and moving around. So this side is false, okay? And this side is true. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say something, and you are to move to whether you think it's true or false, okay? Do you understand that? Yeah. So, here's my first statement, and you tell me whether you think this is true or false. God, I haven't said it yet. You didn't tell me you'd got a mind reader, right? God created the world in 7 days. True or false? Right, okay. Adults, answer. What do you think? True or false? How many of you think true? How many of you think it's false? Right, you've all gone with true. You've changed your mind now because the adults have said false, haven't you? Right, so you all went with true. In fact, God created the world in 6 days, not seven, and on the seventh day he rested. So that statement was false. Do you want to come back? Do you want to come back? All right, and here's my second statement. Come back here. Right, true or false? He's answering right, ask the question. Come back here. Right, true or false? Moses took two of each creature onto the ark with him. True or false? That's the whole point. So you're saying it's true? Yes? And you're all saying it's false? Why is it false? Because the last one was true? True or false, adults? How many say true? How many are saying false? How many of you don't care? The answer is false. It wasn't Moses, it was Noah. It's nearly true, but it was Noah. Okay, here we go. Adam and Eve lived in the Garden of Eden. True or false? Adam and Eve lived in the Garden of Eden. Right, okay. Right, so we've got you two are saying... You two are saying it's false, and you lot are saying it's true. Is that correct? It is true. Adam and Eve lived in the Garden of Eden. Right. The first book in the Bible is Genesis. True or false? The first book in the Bible is Genesis. The first book in the Bible is Genesis. True or false?
Anybody want to borrow a Bible to find out?
Adults? Yes, it's true. The first book in the Bible is Genesis. All right, come back in the middle. Come back. No, she's just checking on truth, telling the truth now. Right, here's your next one then. Right, Saul, are you ready? Saul killed Goliath with one stone. Saul killed Goliath with one stone. True or false? See, she's looking at me, she's going, I don't trust you anymore. You do not know, okay? Yes, we're on another one now. So Saul killed Goliath with one stone. True or false? You're going to false. Where are you going? True or false?
No, you can't have that.
Not yet. You can sing later. No? Right, okay. The answer was... false. Who was it? David. David killed Goliath. Right, here we go. Samuel served with Aaron in the temple. Oh, you don't know this one. You have to think about this one, do you? You're going in the middle, you can't decide. Okay, it was actually false. And it was, who did he serve in the temple with? Eli. Okay, now, there were three wise men who visited Jesus. True or false? There were three wise men who visited Jesus. True or false? It's false. The Bible doesn't actually tell us how many there were. It only mentions three gifts. Okay, come and sit down again. No, they gave three presents, but there could have been seven wise men who gave them. Right. The Apostle Paul used to be called Saul. The Apostle Paul used to be called Saul. No, it's true. Okay, come back in. We've got just a few more. Right, Jesus rose from the grave after 4 days. True or false? Jesus rose from the grave after 4 days. So you're saying it's false. Why is it false? Not five. 3 days. Okay. The last book in the Bible is Revolution. No, that's Ecclesiastes. That's... Are you saying that's... I can't remember which way around I got it now. This is false. You're saying false.
Yeah.
What is it? You're just saying it's false because I'm telling lies now. Okay. It's Revelation, not Revolution. Right? And then we've got Jesus died on the cross between two thieves. True or false?
Hello.
Jesus died on the cross between two thieves is true. It's true. And, right, come in the middle. We've got one last question. One last question.
Careful you don't fall over.
It says, we can trust Jesus because he is the truth. True or false?
Yeah.
False? I think you've missed the purpose of this. Yes, the answer is true. Do you want to come and sit down and let me just finish up? Come and sit down. Come and sit down. It was true. And the thing is, what you need to remember is Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, not a way or a truth. Okay? So, we've heard then that Jesus is the way and the truth, and Adrian's going to take up and follow that on.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks. Right. If the children want to go back and sit, they can carry on sitting at the front if you want. But if you want to go back and sit with your families. I've got a few reading verses now about Jesus asking people to follow him. So the first one was, as Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon called Peter and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. Come, follow me, Jesus said. And that's Matthew 4:18-19. And then in Matthew 9, as Jesus went on from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the tax collector's booth. Follow me, he told him. And Matthew got up and followed him. Jesus said to another man, follow me. And that's in Luke chapter 9. And in John, we're told, the next day Jesus decided to leave for Galilee. Finding Philip, he said to him, follow me. So, we're now going to sing the Follow Me song. Will you come and follow me? Thank you, Janet.
Will you come and follow me?
Okay, so we've been thinking about Jesus being the way, the truth, and the life. As Martin was telling us, Jesus said he is the truth. But we do find it hard at times to know whether somebody is telling us the truth or not. But we can trust that Jesus is telling us the truth. So if he's telling us the truth, and Jesus calls each one to follow him as he is the way to heaven and to life eternal, then that is something that we need to believe. And it makes sense, as when I was talking about maps and everything else and sat nav, it makes sense for us to follow Jesus if we want to get to where he says he's taking us. So we are saying that we can trust him because he is the truth. Each one of us has to choose how we will respond to Jesus's invitation to follow him. His call to follow him is not a call to an easy life. Following Jesus doesn't make things easier. Sometimes it makes things very difficult for us. Sometimes we find that our friends, or people we thought were our friends, laugh at us if we say we're going to church or we're going to go to Sunday school or whatever. They say, wouldn't it be much better to be out at the park playing football on a Sunday morning? But if we follow him, we have a satisfying life relationship with God that has meaning and purpose. So, if you really want to follow Jesus, let's say this prayer together. Lord Jesus, thank you for calling us to follow you. We believe that you are the way, the truth, and the life. Today we choose to put our trust in you. Help us to walk closely with you each day. Thank you for making it possible for us to have eternal life. Amen. And now to sing From Heaven You Came.
Our God, the Serpent King.
Going to have time of prayer now. Lots of times we're told that we should shut our eyes, put our hands together and bow our heads when we pray. I don't want you to do that. I want you to keep your eyes open, because whilst we are praying, whilst I'm leading our thoughts in prayer, I'm going to be showing you some pictures that were taken last weekend of our celebrations. And there's some music behind it. And as we pray, look at the pictures and think about things that they remind us of and everything else. So let us pray. Our Lord, we give you thanks for all that has gone before, all the people that have been in this place over 2 centuries, teaching each other the truth of your word. We thank you that there is room here for everyone to come in, that you call us to love one another. We especially remember those who are in need of our love, your love and compassion at this time. Those who are grieving for loss of loved ones. Remembering Catherine and her sister Sam and family this time. But we can also give you thanks for all the blessings that you have brought upon us. We're told to count our blessings, name them one by one, and we ask, Lord, that you will forgive us that so often we name our woes and our worries and we pile them up instead of actually thinking about all that you have given us. Help us, Lord, as we live our lives to be witnesses to you. The fact that we can work together with other Christians in our community, that they support us and we can support them.
give thanks for food and sustenance, that we can celebrate like we did last week with Ella. But as well as celebrating, we listen, we witness through our buildings, through gathering together. Oh Lord, help us to remember that you have called us to be active, that you have called us to follow you, and that following you means that we should be serving others, that we should be making friends with each other, we should be showing love to one another, that even the worst sinner, we are called to love the person but to hate the sin. Our Lord, we give thanks for those people that need our prayers in our life, for those people who came into our premises last weekend, maybe the first time or the first time for many years. Oh Lord, we just pray that they might have been challenged to think, why have those strange people called Baptists been there for 200 years? We thank you that we're able to share memories. We thank you that we are able to share fellowship. Thank you, Lord, for all your preaching and messages that have been given in this place over the years. Help us, Lord, to remember you, to hold you in our hearts, that as we go forward, we might listen to what you are saying to us, that we might respond, and that we might do what you are calling us to do, that we might have the courage and the strength to step forward in faith, following you, because you know, we know that you are with us every step of the way. And these things we ask in your name. Amen. We're going to finish now singing "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is." Let's stand and sing. Gently. Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Keep us growing day by day as you lead us to the place where you will meet, where we will meet you face to face. And let us share the grace together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Thank you. Mark says you were just a week or two off 13. Are you sure you're only 13?
Well, almost 13.
That's what I meant, almost 13.
Yeah, that's what I meant. This one,
your mom's done well with bringing you one for me.